So, at the next Apple event, the new MacBook Pros will be coming out, including the M1X 16-inch model. But what ports will we see on the new MacBook Pro? Well, today's report shows what we could be getting on the new MacBook Pro. Let me share the latest on this, and of course, the latest on the 2021 new MacBook Pro 16-inch release date and price. So here we are in September, new iPads, iPhones and a new Apple Watch has been announced. So what's next? Well, it can only be the Mac event next with some new MacBook Pros. Going forwards, I've decided for all the new MacBook Pro 16-inch videos like this one you are watching, I am going to give you the latest details on specific reports or info that has been told, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the models that we're going to get, and also the features that we have learnt in previous leaks, and also the prices. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the MacBook Pro 16-inch. Also, put in the comments below what features you'd love to see in the new MacBook Pro, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So, let's start with that report of ports to expect on the new MacBook Pro 16-inch. So, we've had a report earlier this year detailing the ports to expect. The new MacBook Pros are expected to now have three USB-C ports that will be running on Thunderbolt 4 and USB 4 technology. This is an upgrade of the Thunderbolt 3 and USB 3.1 technology inside the current 16-inch MacBook Pro, but it does mean one less USB-C port compared to what we have right now. But what will be changed for that port? Well, it's the return of MagSafe to the MacBook. The current generation MacBook only has USB-C for charging, but many of us, including myself, have missed MagSafe, so it'll be great to have this back. Also, another welcome return is an SD card reader built right in, and also a HDMI port. Again, these have been missing since the last MacBook Pro design, so it's really good to have them back. Personally, I think it's great to add all these ports back to the MacBook. This combined with the new M1X or whatever it will be called, this is looking to be one of the best MacBook Pro designs ever. This also leads me on nicely to say that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they're going to come true with the new MacBooks. I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you're watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what is going to be said about the new MacBooks anyway. So, continuing on with the release date. So, based on Mark Gurman's recent report saying that the MacBook Pros are coming in several weeks, this is most likely going to be the case for a launch event in October and release around a week or so later. Remember, the last time we got an overall design refresh on the MacBook Pros was in October 2016. So, there's a possibility for this. But the exact date, with the exception of the COVID launches in 2020 of the new M1 Max, all previous full releases of MacBooks have come at the end of October, and this has always been in the mid-20 numbers or even the first or second day into November, and it's always been a Friday. In fact, another leaker, Dylan, has also said that the end of October, early November time is on the cards. So based on this info, and remember this is on facts of other full-time MacBook releases, so remember this is not written in stone, we could, and I'll say that again, could see the new MacBooks in our hands on October 22nd or October 29th. But if we get a firm date, this of course will change, but for now this gives you a good time to base on when the release will be. So, just quickly, this channel has just hit over 230,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. And we did a giveaway of a MacBook Pro M1. Well, I've got you some great news, guys. We're doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPad Pro M1 with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Now, anybody can enter in to win this giveaway around the world. It is an international giveaway. But all I want to know from you guys is basically, what Apple tech are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what other tech are you planning to buy if it's not going to be Apple tech? Write it down in the comments below, and make sure at the same time as well to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. So make sure you do that right now, because you'll want to know if you're going to be the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, if you're enjoying this video so far, please make sure to press the like button. Well, let's get back to the video. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far of previous leaks that have painted a picture of the details for the MacBook Pro 16-inch with its price as well. So these are the facts of what we know about the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and of course this could change over time, so make sure you do check out my videos in the future. But anyway, we're expecting a 16-inch XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. This is very similar to the display that we find in the iPad Pro 12.9-inch, and it will feature a resolution of 3072 by 1920, exactly what we get in the standard LED display in the current MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, the difference is most likely we're going to be getting ProMotion 120Hz refresh rate with this. On top for storage options, they will start from 512GB all the way up to 8TB of storage. Then most likely we're going to be getting that M1X chipset inside it, what will be a 12-core CPU and also will feature a 16 or 32-core GPU option depending on the amount of RAM that you pick. And talk about RAM, the options of RAMs will be 16GB, 32GB or 64GB of RAM. It is most likely that the 32-core GPU option will be available with 32 or 64GB of RAM. We're also going to be getting a brand new design with the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and it will be made out of an aluminium body. And you've seen this new design and what it could potentially look like in the renders in this video. For ports, MagSafe is back at last, but at the same time as well, we'll be getting three USB-C ports, and these will be Thunderbolt 4 ports. That's one less than what we get on the MacBook Pro right now, but we will get the return of HDMI 2.1 and also an SD card slot. At the same time, the webcam in the center is going to be that new center stage webcam that will be a 12 megapixel camera. The battery life from the latest leaks that we've been told will be an 8,693 milliamp. So for prices, because things can be a bit of a mix-up depending on what options you pick, I've based this on the lowest amount of RAM, what you can get, and then going up in the storage amounts. So the prices will start at $2,399 for a 512GB option, for 1TB, $2,099, 2TB, $2,999, 4TB, $3,599, and 8TB, $4,799. So that is a summary of the MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, for my thoughts and wishes, my wish is actually to do with the price. Now, over the years, the 16-inch MacBook Pro has gone up and has creeped up quite a bit. So the current base model now starts at $2,400, and if we go back just around that 8 years ago, it started at $1,800. I am hoping that Apple can at least keep the same price and not increase the cost of the next generation MacBook Pro 16-inch. But let me know your thoughts if you agree with this or not, and write in the comments below your wishes what you'd like to see in the new MacBook Pro 16-inch. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, see you soon!